Hey guys, Neomis here. Now for today's video, I want to talk about Marc Roca, Espanyol midfielder, been linked with Arsenal. I'll be giving my thoughts and views on that. Also, Mavropanos been linked away to Arsenal. I'll be giving my thoughts around that and what that really means for Arsenal. But until then, if you haven't done so already, please hit the subscribe button below and like the video. It does help the channel out, as well as supporting the channel in regards to the YouTube algorithm. Now, let's get started. So let's talk about Marc Roca. That's right, Espanyol midfielder. Linked with Arsenal today, literally a couple of hours ago. This is a player that's been linked with us over a year ago now. And I know about 3-4 months ago was linked to Arsenal. But it wasn't a player that I initially had talked about on the channel. But today, a couple of hours ago on Daily Express, it said that Arsenal are looking at Marc Roca and AC Milan are also interested in him. Now, if you don't know, Marc Roca is a deep line playmaker that plays for currently Espanyol, who's at the bottom of the table at the moment. Chances are, before La Liga is over, Espanyol will be struggling down at the end of the table. And if Espanyol do get relegated from La Liga, chances are he's going to be one that is going to be seen as somebody that Espanyol could go and make money off of. And therein lies where Arsenal can really come in to try to buy this guy. So right now he's got a 35 million release clause in his contract. But because of the current financial situation of Espanyol, just based, not even just this season, but just overall as a club, they're not doing great. They could do with money. Arsenal could probably get him for around 20 million. And I mean, overall, Marc Roca is a pretty good player. And to be honest, I see him a lot as being as like a Granit Xhaka replacement. And I do think that with the price tag being as nominal as it is, it could be an opportunity there. But then I started thinking, we've got Guendouzi there who plays in that role. What would that mean for Guendouzi? Would that kind of stifle Guendouzi and his growth? Because, I mean, you probably saw the game that we played against Charlton to kind of get us ready for the Premier League. And that midfield's contained a midfield two of Guendouzi and Maitland-Niles. And definitely, Guendouzi was the playmaker out of the two, you know, in that kind of typical Granit Xhaka role, whilst Maitland-Niles was seen as more of the Lucas Torreira ball-winning midfield type position, which I think, you know, suits him well. So to bring in someone like a Marc Roca, and yes, you do have to say maybe we need that kind of added additional players, but looking forward, we don't want to stifle our young players. And Marc Roca is young, you know, he's only 22, 23 years old. Lots of opportunities to grow there. But I see this deal as we should only do it is unless there's rumblings already going on, unless Granit Xhaka is already planning on leaving or wants to leave. That's the only time that you bring in a guy like Marc Roca into the team. And even then, I still think that Arsenal needs that midfield where it has lots of pace, strength and dynamism in terms of the ability for Arsenal just to conquer teams in midfield. I think a lot of times we just lose games within that midfield. You know, having a ball, a kind of deep line crane maker is great for kind of creating and sticking with that possession football. But I do think that Arsenal need different options going forward at times when it comes to the overall balance of that midfield. So let's see what really happens there. But I think Marc Roca is a solid, solid player, especially if we could get him for the right price. We do have some teams interested in him as well. Like I said, AC Milan before in the running for him. So let's really see what happens there. And then finally, let's talk about Mavropanos. So Mavropanos has now been linked away from Arsenal. So if you don't know, Mavropanos went on loan at the in January to Nuremberg. Obviously, with the COVID stuff, I know he had some injuries earlier on the season. But now then, since the season has started up again in Germany, he's been playing really well. And lots of clubs are said to be interested in Mavropanos. Now, I know he's been doing well, and I know we sent him out there for game time, and he hasn't actually had that much opportunity to be around Mikel Arteta. I believe when Arteta started, he only was there for about a month. So, and I know, looking, reading in some interviews, Mavropanos said that he wasn't going to be able to get a lot of game times at Arsenal. So they decided to send him out on loan to get those game times, get that experience, which is what we all want for our young players. It's what I want for a lot of our young players, is to get those games ready. So today, when I'm hearing the news that Mavropanos could be leaving Arsenal in order to raise cash, very surprised by it, but still wanted to kind of bring it to everyone's attention. Do I think it's going to happen? Probably not. And the only reason why I say that is because right now, Arsenal are in a situation whereby we need to invest in our youth. And we don't have a lot of sellable assets. Yes, Arsenal need money, but how much are you really going to get from Mavropanos? 10, maybe 15 mil tops? You know, he's largely unproven. And yes, he's been playing really well at Nuremberg, but he's largely an unproven player. And I don't see our team really spending a lot of money on him. Now, if a team came in with 30 million for him, great, then do what you have to do. But right now, largely, I still think that there's an opportunity for Mavropanos to continue to grow, continue to progress on loan, and then to come back and to Arsenal and potentially either start or come up off the bench. I mean, because that's what it's all about. You know, and it doesn't have to be Mavropanos. I feel the same way in the likes of Zach Medley and Daniel Ballard, who come through our academies. Like, these players need games. Like, let's give them games. Let's see what they can do. And this is part of the reason why guys like Mustafi and, for me, Socrates, they just have to go. Because they are definitely taking up opportunities that could be for some of the young players like Mavropanos. So for me personally, I still want to see Mavropanos get a chance at Arsenal. I think that for a young player, you just need to give him games. You know, let's see how he does 10 games in a season, you know, and see how that works, and then judge him. But I think right now it's still very, very much too early to kind of, you know, decide on Mavropanos' Arsenal career being over. But guys, what do you think on Mavropanos? For me, like I said, I think he should stay, get an opportunity. But do you think we should sell him, get rid of him? Or do you think we should keep him and see what he has? I mean, he's got lots of potential. His physique, like there's lots of things to work there. And yes, it will take time. But we've got a long way to go. And there's no shortcuts in terms of our progression kind of going forward. So leave your comments below on what you think about Mavropanos leaving. Also, what do you think of Mark Rocha being rumoured to Arsenal from Espanyol? Continue to leave your comments below. Please continue to like the video, and I will see you all next time.